Hello everybody, I'm Bageler Bagel Plays, and today I'm going to be taking a look at a cool game that was just released on Early Access called Scrap Mechanic. This is a cool like physics-based creative making contraption sort of game. I'd say it's kind of a... it's neat, just take my word for it. Currently $20 on Steam. Losing my voice there. And let's jump into it. First things first, you can choose between a male or female character. I'm just gonna stick with male. Let's do a new game. Right now there's only creative mode. I think they're planning on adding a like survival or some other kind of modes. Probably survival. But for right now, it's just creative, which is fine. World name, I'll just do like, awesome town. And you can choose between like a terrain world, which is kind of what you see in the background here, or flat world, which is what you'd expect. It's just a flat world. It's just completely flat and desolate and soul crushing. So we're gonna go terrain. Private, I guess that's like if you wanna put a password on, I'm assuming. Because there's multiplayer, should mention that. So you can play with friends, which is certainly a good thing, especially in a game like this. Some settings you can mess with, I'm not gonna bother with them. So let's get going. Let's create this world. I have played it some already. I gotta say, it's for an early access game that was just released, I'm quite impressed with it. Alright, so here's this little thing opening, telling you what to do. It's very good with in terms of like tutorial stuff. They kinda don't just throw you off in the world and let you figure it out. They do let you know quite a bit. Because there was that little opening thing. Also, you start with this handbook. If you can see that I'm holding here. Mechanics handbook. And if you just click, that'll open it up. And you can see all this cool stuff. It's all kinds of everything you need to know here. All these tabs at the top here and everything. I'm not going to really go into this too much. Also, there's videos for some of this stuff. You can see up there. I'm not really going to go into this because... sort of know what I'm doing already, kind of a little bit, somewhat. I don't, but I can pretend I do enough to maybe fool a couple people, so that's good enough for me. I think, as far as I can tell, I can't tell if there's multiple worlds that you can spawn in, or if it's like, I don't think it's like procedurally generated or anything, because it seems pretty handcrafted and... didn't say anything about procedurally generated worlds, so I don't know. I kind of think it's just one world, but it will like spawn you in a different point each time. So I'm not really sure, but that would be my guess. Just a quick little thing. But who knows, in the future, that's probably something they'll add, is like procedurally generated worlds and that kind of stuff. Although, I don't know. So first thing, I'll open up the inventory. Show you guys what we got here. So these are all the items in the game so far. Obviously, since this is creative mode, you don't really have to you don't really have to gather resources or build stuff, you know, it's just kind of craft things. It's all kind of here. Here you can see under the items, you can see like a little line, colored line. Blue is sort of like these building block sort of things. Orange is like stuff, items that do things. Very descriptive of me. I know. So like these are all items that basically have a purpose. And then green is pretty much just items that are there, decorative items and assorted other items and stuff. And over here we have the tools. Which we got the lift, which I'll show you more about that in a second. Sledgehammer, which you can basically hit stuff with it. Connection tool, I can show you more about that in a minute too. And the handbook. So start off by building a little thing here, just kind of show you guys the building. So you can build just one single block like that, or you can click and drag and build like a big platform. Also, there's these sort of like arrows on the block. If you press Q, you can change that, and that basically controls like when you click and drag. It's like this, you can't build up, it's only flat. And if you have it like that, then you can't build across, so it kind of locks it into place, which does make it easier for building. Just kind of keeps everything nice and neat. And that's Q to rotate that. Also, you can rotate as you're building, which is a good feature. I'm very happy they did that. I'll just build a little wall here. What else? Also, if you're dragging and you want to cancel, you can right-click. Also, when you drag, you hold down the left mouse button. Pretty simple stuff. I'll just build a quick little house here. Probably should use a different material for the walls so it doesn't all blend together. But oh well. That's fine. Build this up here. And so I got a little house here. I'm gonna put a roof on. Roof. Alright, and then we'll just take out a little doorway here. That's not gonna be very centered, is it? Let's do like that, sort of centered. Alright. Centered. That's pretty centered. Alright, so that's basic little building thing. And then we get into some more kind of exciting bits. So I guess I have that already. So the first thing you're probably gonna mess with is a bearing, which you can set down here. Basically these will let things rotate. So if I were to put some wooden blocks on it, just like that, then if I get my hammer out, I can hit it, spin it around. Look at that. It moves. And this is kind of a big part of this game so far. It's bearings. You can also add like a I already had a motor out, but I'll get another motor. Get a couple of these out too, just to show them off. So if you add like a motor here, I don't know why everything's kind of in the ground right now. Oh, I can put the motor on the wall. That's cool. So get a motor out, then I'll take the connect tool. So basically this tool... Alright, I should need to explain here. So, you have this connect tool. And this basically lets you connect things together. So like the bearing here, you can't connect building block stuff, but you can... It's basically you can connect together the orange items. And so you can just click and drag to connect things. And then if I turn the motor on, then that will start spinning, but it's going to hit the motor. So let me actually move that somewhere where it's not going to run into it. And then we'll connect them again. Whoops. Boom. So, get it moving a little bit. Going pretty slow. You can make it go pretty fast too. a little too fast there. Well, let's just turn it down to like there-ish. Nah, let's make it a little bit slow. That's a little bit too fast for me. So you're right there. It's perfect. Not that this is serving any purpose, but just for demonstration. You can also right-click to change the direction it spins. So that's neat. And then also, if you want to use like buttons, you can put down a button, connect that, and then to activate it, you just press a button and that'll turn it back on. And there's, so far there's three different kinds of buttons. There's that kind, which is like an on-off, or a click it and it turns off or turns on or whatever. Then there's this button, which only works when you press it down. And then there, oop, Take out some wall there. Whoops-a-daisy. And then put, this is a sensor. And just connect that real quick. So basically how this works is when you walk in front of it, or when something goes in front of it, it turns on. So yeah, that's your three basic kinds of switches. So obviously this has a lot of potential. There's also, I should show that off right now too. There is a, where is it, controller, which just took out some more wall there. Whoops. Let's just put this down right there. Connect that up so it quits going and making noise and being annoying. So I put a controller down. And then we can connect the controller to that probably. No, maybe just do it to the switch. Alright. You can do other cool things with this, but I'm still not great at it. So we use... Oh, it's because I have this. I see. Never mind. I got it. So get that one. Get that one out. Can't disconnect it. We're just going to redo it there. All right. Connect that there. And I guess we should have that connected. And then you can control how much it spins, basically. So if I want to have it turn like 90 degrees or something... When I press the button, it'll turn 90 degrees, and then go back. Or I could have it turn 90, and then go back 60, and then go forward 210. I think this should work. And it follows that amount. And you can have, like, if I were to get another bearing out, there. And put that right here, and like do something like that, and then connect that to there. Then there's like a second thing for the bearing here, so then I can have this one go like that, and that, and that, and that. And then when I hit the button, and they rotate around and do really nothing right there, but. yeah, so that's kind of the basic stuff, I suppose, for that. So that obviously wasn't the best, like, demonstration just because it didn't really do anything. So I'll just do some. This wasn't actually my creation, but this is on a tutorial video that the devs made, but I'm going to steal it. Make a simple door here. So put a bearing down, put the door here. That might be too thick. I'm gonna take one off. And then we'll just put a controller down. That's the wrong way. Controller down, and like a button. And then connect these bad boys up. And then do this. I think it'd have to be negative 90 because it's at a different angle. I'm not sure. We'll see if that works. Yep, there we go. We got a door. So, yeah, that'd be kind of an example of using some of this stuff together. So, now we built a little house. I think next we should build a vehicle, right? Yeah, I think so. So, for vehicle, you're going to want to use this lift, which basically is a tool you can place. I think you can only put down one at a time. And what you can do is you have it there and you can lift it up using the arrow keys. So, like, up and down on the arrow keys will lift it up. And you can go really high. How high does it go? Oh, that's how it goes. Or you can make it low or whatever. You can also stand on it, so if you need to get up somewhere, you can like jump up on it and lift it up and see everything. Kind of neat. Or you can build stuff on it, and it'll kind of all stay. It'll sort of say like centered on here or anchored on. So if I were to just start building a car, for some reason I'm making it out of wood. It's probably not the best material for a car, but that's okay. Let's also build a little bit over here. Get a good little platform going here. We got this, and then we can lift the whole thing up or lower it. Let's do this. It's gonna be kind of a weird car, but that's okay. I'm gonna get some different materials out. Let's build with like this and this and this, just so we can get some different different materials going here. I'm gonna build a little thing there. Actually, do I want this a little bit wider? I want this a little bit wider. Let's make this a little bit wider. It's gonna be a big car. Wrong material. 1 second. I messed up. I done goofed. Alright, get that. Okay. Then we'll build a nice little tower here. This is gonna be a weird car. It's like a reverse car. That's what it is. I kind of was messing around and I built one of these earlier, but it was a little bit different. And I figured out some problems that I had with it, but let me mess with this a little bit. Figured out some problems that I had with it, and I think I can perfect the design now. If I'm humble. Is that the same height? Not at all. Let's take a couple off there. That same height now? I think. I can't really tell. I shouldn't have built this how I did. I kind of already messed up a little bit, but I can fix it. Take like two off there. Is that going to be the same height? Same height. Alright. And I'm sure there's an easier way to do this, but... Is that the same height? That looks like the same height. Wow, I got it right the first time. Alright, then, what are we going to do next? Next, we're going to build out here. Just little things like this. Actually, let's do this. And that. And then we'll put some... These are suspension. Put our suspension here. And then, for some reason, you can't put like wheels and stuff directly onto the suspension. So you gotta put a block. Like, the suspension things can only connect to blocks. I don't know why it's like that, but it is. So, whatever. Alright, I know this isn't looking like a car. And to be honest, it isn't gonna look like a car even when I'm done. But, just have some faith in me. Because I think it's going to turn out to be pretty neat. It's not. It's going to be an absolute train wreck, but that's fine. Alright, so got that. Then we're going to need steering. So let me get a bearing out. And we're going to want that to be right there. And I guess this will be the front up here. And right there. And then put... lock there, and let's put some off-road suspension. Also, all the items have little tooltips off to the side there, so this is off-road suspension, and I think it's a bit more bouncy. This is sport suspension, and it's a little bit less bouncy, so put the less bouncy ones on the side. That could be weird. I actually didn't really think that through. Probably that's probably not gonna work very well, actually, now that I think about it. Don't judge me. I don't really know what I'm doing. Let's just get rid of those, because that's actually probably going to be weird to have that on the side. Probably gonna make everything just, whoops, just weird, not work very well. I didn't really think it through. I kind of just started going. I wasn't thinking about it. You do have to think about stuff quite a bit in this game. Quite a bit of planning involved with everything. Woo. How many blocks is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. So, let me put a bearing here. And then we go boop, boop. This. Boop, 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 boop. Actually, I'll do that in a second. How many did I do over there? 2 blocks before the suspension? Alright. Boop, boop. This is gonna be great, you guys. Just trust me. And when I say great, I mean absolute disaster. Kinda messed that up. Alright. I keep forgetting you can drag. I'm trying to be all careful and make sure I do it correctly. Not that there's a correct way to do it, but... Alright, we'll lift this up a bit. I think I'm going to have these towers go one beneath the platform. Alright, I think we're good there. Now we put bearings here, like so. And here, there, and there, and let me get some tires out. There's big tires and little tires here. There's these little tires, and there's these big tires, and these are the big tires. Because why not? You know, I didn't put suspension on these back ones. Dang it. That sucks. There's not a great system for... if you like mess up in the middle, because everything's kind of connected, and so if you at least haven't found a great system, I guess I could be missing out on something, but it seems like when you I forgot to put suspension here, and so I'd delete the whole thing, because if I would have just deleted a little section in the middle, then it would have fallen off and gotten all messed up and stuff. So it seems like you kind of have to know what you're doing ahead of time. I'm sure that adding in a system for that wouldn't be the hardest thing in the world, but I'm sure they'll be able to handle doing that, and that's probably something that'll happen at some point. But it's kind of a pain right now, because if you make a mistake, then you have to like delete everything lots of times. It's sort of a bummer. But I guess you just gotta plan stuff out a bit first. But I could just totally see making a whole magnificent creation, and then you get to the end and you mess something up, and you just gotta go like way back, and it'll be a huge pain. And just a giant bummer. Alright, so we got that. Then let's get a seat here. Man, what direction is that? Want it that way, yeah, okay. Let's put that like right there. And then let's get a motor. And so these electric engines, which is what I used earlier for powering the little spinny things, they're supposed to be good for that kind of stuff, I think. And then a gas engine is good for vehicles. I'm not 100% sure why. I didn't really look at it that closely, but that's what it said, so I'm just going to accept it. All right, so we got an engine. We got a thing. Let's build, actually. Let's get this. Let's build a little... roof. Oh, wait, that's not the same height. Is that the same height? That's the same height. Probably should have checked to make sure these were the same height before. Oh, and that doesn't. Okay, we'll do that. And that's the same height. So I think it's just. So I kind of messed up a bit. You know what? It's probably fine. I don't know. I'm just gonna not worry about it. Hope it turns out okay. Mess that up though. See, it kind of works, sort of. It worked out fine, hopefully. There. And I'm walking all over stuff and getting stuck. And there. Alright. That wheel's a little bit lower than all the other ones. That is okay, hopefully. And what else do we need? I don't know that we need anything else. I think I should probably wall this in a bit more, though. Just because it might be a good idea. Hopefully I'll be able to see out of it without that. That could be a problem. Well, it's not a beautiful car. But, you know what? I don't even care. Well, I care a little bit, but... what's kind of a see-through thing we could put in front here? Are there any windows here? There's a shoe. Could put a shoe on here. We're gonna put those on the front. Shoe. And shoe. That's the wrong spot. Need to be one over. Shoe. Still not symmetrical. Oh well. I think... You know what? I don't even care. Alright, we're just going to do that and just kind of wall this in. I know it looks terrible. Don't judge me. Okay? I don't know what I'm doing. Alright, then let's put a door here. Because I made that amazing door earlier. It's going to be like a house car. This is going to be sweet. Alright, and then we put a bearing here, and then we put a switch there, and I don't have a controller. And then we get out a controller, and another kind of block, let's do metal. And let's just build it so it goes out. That's probably the right size, maybe. And then a controller. Oops. That. Alright. Now I think it's time to start connecting stuff. I'm gonna do that because it looks weird having that big of an open space. Alright. I could probably do something. Alright, I'm gonna get creative here. I'm going to get creative. It could absolutely fail, but I have to try. Okay, we do that. And wait, one second. Let me do that. Do that. And that. Alright, I think this might work. This might work. I don't know how I'm gonna do a roof then. Do it like one down, how about that? Yeah, I'll take. No. I need this one. I got it. You guys, stop judging me. I got this. Alright. That. And I'm not going to be able to get up there to do this. That's okay. It's going to look a little ugly. But that's the way it goes. Alright. Do. So this might work. We're gonna see if it works. And then let's build a roof here. coffee roof. Alright, so let's see. This is gonna work. Maybe. Alright. And then let's put a switch right here and a controller. Okay. This might work. This might not. So we gotta connect that. Connect that. Let's see. So that would need to go like that much, maybe? Oh. You can't use switches and stuff while it's on a lift. Uh-oh. That didn't go down straight. Alright, I'll deal with that in a second. It's the wrong direction. Whoops. Okay, let's go negative 270. See how that works. Look at that. That worked. Look at that. That worked perfectly. Sweet. Oops. Switch. Oh yeah. Of course the wheels and stuff are a bit messed up, but that's okay. Hopefully once I connect everything officially, it'll work. Alright. I just wanted to make sure that that would work. So now we're going to actually go through and really connect everything. First we got to do this, though. Never mind. We're almost about to go through and really connect everything. Is that going to... Whoops. Is that going to work? Or is that going to go the... Nope, that is the wrong direction. We need to go positive 90. I can never tell which, if it needs to go positive or negative. I kind of just guess and I'm generally wrong. Alright, so we got the door working. Everything's good there. I'm not sure, can you just put a switch on the outside and to have it connect to that? No. That's annoying. So I don't think you can open this from the outside. Alright, whatever. So, let's put it back on the lift. Connect everything now. So we want that to go up there, because that's the control bearing. And then we want that also to connect to the motor. We want the motor to connect to all the wheels. This is gonna work, you guys. I wasn't planning on making a car this crazy, but I kinda got carried away. Which I think is gonna happen a lot in this game. We wanna make sure all the wheels are going in the right direction. That's right, that's right. Is it right over there? That's wrong. Change that. And that is right now. Okay. Okay. We're gonna try this out. This probably is gonna fail miserably because I went a little bit too crazy. But we're gonna try. So we close the door. Then open that up. Then we get in. Can't see anything. I think Alt is that, yeah. If you hold down Alt and scroll, you can zoom in and out. I did not turn the motor on. Let's put the motor up a ways. We're probably gonna need it. Quite a bit of power on there. Alright. Steering's backwards, but that's okay. It works, kind of. Look at that. Steering is inverted, but I'm just gonna accept that for now. Look at that. I have a working car. You know what? You know what we're gonna do? You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna take this one step further and put thrusters on the back. Because why not? Everyone needs a little bit of thrusters in their life. This is more like a house than a car. It's like a house that drives. Okay. I think I'm doing this right. This could be wrong, but I think this will work. Possibly. Maybe. Don't judge me if it doesn't work. Alright. Let's try this out. Haha! Worked. Look at that. Oh yeah. Handles quite a bit better than I was expecting, actually. Oh no, it crashed. Go. Nope. Dang it. Yeah. Alright. Built a car. So, I think I went over most of the stuff I was wanting to. I don't know, there's really a whole lot else here I was really wanting to go over. So, I think I'm gonna end it here. And, next time I'll come back and build something cooler than this sad, sad contraption. But, I don't know, I'm pretty happy with it actually. I'm happier than I probably should be with it. It actually doesn't handle that great. It seemed to in the beginning, it doesn't. Kind of drifts a lot. So, yeah. Oh, hit a rock. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys think that my creation is completely amazing and unbeatably awesome. Yeah, next time I'll build something cool. I want to build like a hovercraft or something. I feel like that'd be pretty neat with those thrusters. That, actually, I want to do something real quick. One second. This seems like fun. I saw the devs do it in the video, and now I want to try. You ready for this? Oh, I need to connect it. Connect. Switches on. Where'd it go? I hear it. It's gone forever. Okay. Well, so that is the first little bit here of Scrap Mechanic. I think it's definitely a good game, especially considering it's in early access. And it's... I'm excited to see what happens with it. So definitely if you are interested, go check it out. I think you probably won't be disappointed. And thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.